Today, we're going to talk about competition shooting. Iba naman tayo. Mga techniques, tactics, stuff like that. Diba? So, I'm going to share a few tips along the way. Maybe you guys can pick up a few lessons. Diba?
Sige, 1608.
Was a competition in Fort Magsaysay, and this is a very nice stage. Okay, so himay-himay natin saysayan. If they say to you, review the course of fire, you review the course of fire. Talagang pumunta ka doon, go around it, analyze the stage. Kasi, when I was there, nakikita ko, a few of my opponents were taking the shots on the left side, may nagpatong dyan, on the right side, may nagpatong din, doon sa barrier, and meron din mga dumadive sa loob, they'll take like 10 steps forward, you can see all the targets from there. So may mga pumapasok doon, and some few, daring, just taking the shot standing up, di ba? So, meron naman like, took a shot and then medyo dumapapa after the shot. So here, dapat, analyze the stage, know where your target is, spot the target, and then memorize where you will land or where you will stand or where will you lie down if you're taking it prone. On this stage, I decided to take it prone. Why? Okay, during the review, as you can see, nakita ko na yung target na yan. I think this is a 12 plate target. Disregard nyo yung mga papers ha, kasi hindi kasali yan. This is a multi-stage, this is multi-discipline stage eh. Ginagamit dito ng mga pistolero, so dito naman, kaming mga rifle shooters, amin yung plate na malalayo. If I'm not mistaken, this is a 90 to 150 meters distance. I think this is a 10-inch plate or something like that. 12 rounds, okay? 12 targets on the different levels, different positions. Yan. Nakakalat yan on the field. Okay? Now, when I was reviewing, ha, nakita ko in one point, nakita yung target at this certain position. Now, tatandaan mo yung position na yun, nakita mo lahat ng target. Okay? Now, and then, you will go down on the ground, reviewing to, ha, and to see if you can see the target a feet from the ground. Kasi pag hindi mo ginawa yan, inanalyze mo siya, nakatayo ka. Once you're taking the shot na on the actual match na, pagbaba mo, pag prone mo, may bato pala doon o mayroong mound dyan o mayroong damo dyan, hindi mo na nakita yung target mo. You will move your body to another position just to take that shot. Eh, yun lang, talo ka na agad doon eh. Sayang yun, di ba? So, analyze, spot their target. Kung nakikitas in one position, take it there. Now, I decided to go prone on this one kasi some opponents are taking it standing up. Pwede naman yon if you're really that good, di ba? Kung talagang kayang-kaya ng muscle mo kasi this has muscle fatigue. Nahihirapan yan. After 3 shots, ha, yung baril mo, kung mabigat yan, that will wobble. Hindi mo na makukuha yan, di ba? Kahit gano'ng kagaling, hindi mo ma-stabilize yan, no? Unless gaanan mo, di ba? Kaya some people are going light, some people are going heavy. Di ba? Pero dito kasi, ha, as you can see, I'm using a standard gun. Wala akong scope dyan. These are all iron sights, di ba? Okay. Now, during my analysis, I chose this position, nakita ko lahat. Okay? As you can see. Now, I will go prone. Before I do that, analyze mo muna what's on your body. Di ba? Your belt is on your body. Your magazine is on your body. Now, this is a 12-round stage. So, ang isang magazine natin is 30 rounds. Okay? Now, dalawang magazine yan just to take that shot. Will you sacrifice that extra mag na magdadala ka pa? Diba? So, you analyze. Pwede mong tanggalin yun. You don't have to bring extra mag. Why? Well, kung naglolo ko ang baril mo and you do not trust your gun, you do not trust your magazine, magdala ka. So dapat talaga yung relationship ng gun mo and you, dapat talaga kabisado mo siya and kabisado kanya eh. Ano yan eh? Love affair. It's a love affair. To take off my magazines. Why? Kasi I will go prone. Once you go prone, breathing becomes difficult. Lalo na sa mga malalaking daddy tummies na katulad na natin, di ba? So it becomes very difficult, di ba? So ang sa shooting kasi kasamang breathing dyan eh. So pag-uusapan natin yan sa mother time. Pero dito kasi, ito muna himay-himay natin. We'll take it to the surface level muna. Now, the breathing is very important. So take out any obstruction that can hinder your breathing. Tandaan nyo palagi yan. Once you're going prone, ha? Iba yung usapan sa takbuhan. So here, you must make a decision. Kung kabisado mo yung baril mo, kabisado ka niya, do not take a second magazine. Okay? Dito ata, I think I decided just to load 25 rounds, di ba? Kumbaga, kabisado ko yung magazine na ginamit ko dyan eh. Now, here, pagpipili ng magazine, ha, you're going prone. Pwede ka dito mag 20 round mag, di ba? If you're using your muscle lang. What do I mean by using the muscle? Pag nakaganyan ka lang, oh, free float yan halos. You're just using the muscle. I'll show you, ha? Okay. Firearm, unloaded, no magazine, no bolt, no trigger, okay? Gayahin natin si the shooter. Tinatanggal niya lahat. Okay, this is my competition gun. So, pinagpapahinga ko talaga ito once in a while. Okay? Alright. What do I mean by muscle, di ba? Okay. This is what I mean by muscle only. Now, eto gagawin mo itong stability point mo. The other one, stability point. This is prone na. Kunyari nakatapa tayo. Doing that, oh, see that? Now, makikita mo, eto, spear muscle, umahawak sa kanya yan, oh. See? It's moving like that. Yan, di ba? Nakahawak. Muscle only yan. So, the support of your gun, nanggagaling lang lahat sa muscle mo and sa bone structure mo. Okay? This, medyo magalaw to. If you're breathing and stuff like that, kagalaw yan kahit papano, di ba? Now, what do I mean by choosing your right magazine? Okay. Here we go. Choosing, eto ah, we will go to this topic sa mother time. Ito, brief rundown lang to. Okay? Now, sa mga magazine, may mga sizes yan. Di ba? See that? Now, tatandaan nyo, if you're going prone, gagamit ba kayo ng 40-rounder? Di ba? Lalo na sa mga nakad-bipad, ha? We will talk about it some other time. Yung bipad na yan. Kunyari, standard muna tayo. Wala muna ng bipad. Okay? No bala, ha? No bala. Yung mga okok dyan, baka magalit sa akin, ha? Okay. Pag landing mong ganyan, yan, di ba? Di ba? Mahaba to eh, right? This is a 40-rounder. Pag baba mo ba, and you're lying flat on the ground, pag medyo mataas yung magazine mo, tataas ka rin ganyan, di ba? So, is that your comfort shooting position? Kuha mo, di ba? So, will you use a 40-round mag on that shot? Di ba? Oh, ngayon, gagamit ka ba ng 20-rounder na mababa. So, walang tulong eh. Kasi, tumatama na yung grip mo eh. So, nakatulong ba yung pagpatong mo sa magazine? No. Gagamit ka ba ng a little bigger like that? No. Gagamit ka lang ng mga gantong 30-rounder. See that? To use it as your monopod. Diba? Kasi, this will help you. Okay? This will help you like that. Oo. Pag nakadapa ka na, oh, stabilize mo yan. See that? You get what I mean? Now, kung ang magazine mo, hindi mo kabisado, don't do it. Kasi, if you did not practice on that prior to the match at doon mo lang gagawin, don't ever make patong your magazine on the floor. Tapos gagamitin mo siya. Doon ka mag-experiment sa match? No. No. Matatalo ka niyan. It will jam. 50% of the time, it will jump. Ngayon, tatandaan mo na yung mga magazines mo na it's working for that kind of situation. Kuha mo? So, ano lesson? Magazines are very important kung gagamitin mo siya as a support tool for your weapon. Now, if you're using a bipod, ibang usapan yan. Kasi, yung stability mo galing na sa harap. Ang pinag-uusapan na lang dun yung haba ng magazine mo. Kasi, baka naman yung bipod mo, ganito lang kahaba, yung magazine mo, ganito kahaba. So, it will do that swingy thing like that, di ba? So, nangyayari yan eh. So, pag-usapan natin yan sa mother time, okay? So, we're going back. So, Important is yung stance also. Now, as you can see, ini-spread ko ngayon yung paa ko dyan, di ba? Now, dito, pagdapa ko pa lang, as you can see, yung natural position ko is geared toward the left. Kung nakita mo yung buka ko, medyo nasa left side yung buka from the body, pagka ganyan, no? See, as you can see in this video, oh, ayan, no? So, medyo nakapael ako on the left side, okay? Yan ang mga natural shooting position kesa sa paderecho. Kuha mo. Now, dito, dapat your feet must lay flat on the ground all the time. Feet flat on the ground. Ano yan eh? Dapat talaga, hindi ka nakaganyan, talagang igaganyan mo yung feet mo. Flat on the ground. But here, isipin mo, taking this position ha, nung pagbaba ko, I felt something on my leg that is not natural. So, I had to make a decision while firing my rifle that there's something going on in my rear that is not right. Isipin mo, pumuputo ka na, nag-a-analyze ka pa na may mali sa likod. So, ano yung mali sa likod na yun? As you can see in the video, so dapat, yung body awareness mo is very important. So, during this stage, oh, sino mo, dapat yan flat ang feet ko eh. But, I didn't flatten my left foot, di ba? Kasi, parang may mali eh. So, I had to take the shot in an awkward position like that kasi lalampas na. Alright? So, I did not anticipate that but I corrected it. Kasi, pag finalatin ko yan at lumabas yung feet ko dun sa border na yan, lahat ng shot that I took from there, penalty yan. Talo ka na. Get it? So, as you can see, naka-tiptoe in a way yan, no? Pero, ang natural shooting position, flat yan dapat, ha? Remember that all the time. So, body awareness, alam mo dapat, yung sensory perception mo is very important. Kahit pumuputo ka at nag-a-analyze ka na on this side, kinukumpit mo na lahat yan, pero may nangyayari sa likod, dapat kumpitin mo rin yun. And this happens split of a second, dapat kabisado mo rin yung body mo. Alright?